So let's look at what collaboration, source control, and continuous integration and delivery, which we refer to as CI/CD, looks like with the Power Platform in GitHub. So here's a Power App that our team has been building to track time off requests. So I can see my current leave requests as well as the status of them, my leave balance, company holidays. But a feature request we've been frequently getting is I can filter my leave request by pending and approval states, but not declined. And so we could just edit this app in production, republish the changes, but it's likely that we're going to want to create some traceability for these changes and have them be tested prior to just deploying them straight into production. And so this is really what GitHub is great about. So we're going to use GitHub to see what it might look like to kind of work through this entire workflow from kind of requesting this feature to actually building it out with the Power Platform to deploying it into production with GitHub Actions. So here we are inside of GitHub and we're looking at the repository for my time off app. And so think of a repository as just a giant folder that's going to track all the changes that I make over time. And so you can see here within these folders, there can be subfolders, there can be files. And so what we can do with GitHub is we can represent our Power Platform solution as a GitHub repository. Another cool thing about GitHub is we have this concept of branches, and branches are just copies of my main folder. And so within this, I can create branches for things like my main branch, which is typically my production code. I could have a development branch. And in each of those branches, I can collect multiple changes. So say I'm working on a 1.0 release. I can put all those in a development branch, track them over time. And when I'm ready to release, I can actually take all the changes in that branch, in that folder, and bring them into the main directory with something called a pull request. So we'll return to GitHub later, but right now I want to show what it'd look like to actually create a feature request. So we'll come over into issues, and GitHub has really great integration for things like project management. And so I can come in and I can create a new issue, and I'm going to say add declined filter capability. And we'll go ahead and submit that new issue. And I'm going to go ahead and assign myself. And I can leave comments, I can collaborate with other members of my team, I can do all that right here, and all my issues will show if I go to this issues tab. I can do things like add milestones, labels, that sort of thing. So there's a lot of really cool functionality I can do for collaborating with others inside of GitHub. Okay, so we've created this issue. The developer building this app sees this issue. Let's go back and actually create the fix for this issue and see what it looks like when we wire that up to CI/CD with GitHub Actions. So here we are inside of the Power Apps and Power Platform portal again, and you can see here I've opened the time off request solution. And a solution is just a container for a lot of Power Platform things. So in this case, it's a Canvas-based Power App, but I could also put things in here like Power Automate flows. And so in this case, I've gone ahead and added my leave request to this solution. And what we're actually gonna do with GitHub is we're gonna represent this solution in source control. So that's what we just saw when we were over at GitHub, when we were looking at the structure for our repository, we saw a solution folder. And so that's just a code representation of what's inside this solution. You see, I also have different environments that I've created. So I have a development environment. This is where I'm actually making my changes on my app. I have a build environment. This is where I might be testing the changes that I've made. And then I have a production environment. And this is the environment where the apps live that my end users are actually using with the Power Platform. So let's go ahead and actually update this leave request app. So you can see here, we have pending and approved. We don't have declined. Let's go ahead and actually make that change. So lucky for me, as the developer, it's a super easy change. I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to add filter declined. And you can see that the UI updates, we have declined. I'm going to go ahead and save. And I'll come back over into here and I'll publish these changes as well. And now you can see that all changes are changed and published. So if we come back over to the solution and I refresh this, it says, 1 second ago, just gonna refresh to make sure. So 13 seconds ago, my leave request tablet app was done. And so we're in our development environment, but what we actually wanna do is we wanna take this, pull this into source control. We were gonna create a new branch with these changes in GitHub. And remember, a branch is just a different version of that main folder that contains the changes. So let's jump over to GitHub. And here I'm on this GitHub Actions tab. We used issues earlier, we're using GitHub Actions now. these actions are just things that we can do. They're workflows that I want to do inside of GitHub. So based off something that happens in this folder, I may want to trigger some action. So in this case, I may want to trigger the ability to go and get the latest solution from the Power Platform environment and bring that into GitHub. So let's go ahead and do that now. So we'll go back over to actions and I'm going to click on this export and branch solution. And we're actually just going to view this workflow file. And the really cool thing about our GitHub Actions integration is that I don't have to really do anything to actually make all of this automation work. We've gone ahead and defined that for you. So you can see here, there's different kind of steps and jobs that happen within this, and we'll see what this looks like in a second. But there's not really any code I'm writing here. All I'm doing is specifying some properties. So for instance, my environment URL or my username and my solution name. So there's really not actually much I'm having to do as far as a developer to actually get this integration to work. So let's go back to the GitHub Actions tab. I'm going to select Export and Branch, and we're going to go ahead and run this workflow. So I'll click Run Workflow. And you can see that the Export and Branch workflow solution is now showing as queued. We'll click on Export from Dev, and our workflow is going to start and run through a series of actions that's going to take my solution from the Power Platform, bring that into GitHub by creating a new branch, put those changes in that branch, and we'll be able to track all the changes that I'm making to that solution inside of that development branch without affecting that production folder that we had, that main folder inside of GitHub. And so what this does is creates a really nice traceability for all the changes that I'm making with the Power Platform. And as you can see, it's going through and running those steps that I actually had in that workflow definition file that I just showed. And so it's going to run through each of these, and when we're done with this, what we should have is a branch that contains my changes. Okay, so now our GitHub action has completed. So let's return to this code view. And this should be unchanged. You see 22 minutes ago, 5 hours ago, 2 hours ago, nothing has actually changed right here. And that's because remember, we were exporting to a branch. So you see now when I click on this branches button, I see time off request. And so if I click on this, I can see the most recent change was 31 seconds ago. I can also come over here into commits and I can see all the changes that were made. So if I wanna go back and roll back to a particular change, the really cool thing about putting this into source control is we have that traceability of all the changes I've made. And so we can see that this branch is one commit ahead of main. So that just means it's one change ahead of main. So we'll just go ahead and create what's called a pull request. And really a pull request is just a request to pull the changes that are in one branch into that main branch for production. And so I'll go ahead and I'm gonna say fix issue number 3, because that's the issue we're fixing. I'm gonna create a pull request. And I'm gonna go ahead and merge this pull request. Great, so our issue has been fixed, we merged the changes. And if I go back over to my code, you'll see that the latest change was 1 minute ago. So now what we've done is we've taken the changes that were in this branch and brought them into the main branch. And so this might be where I would deploy to an intermediate environment for testing, but we're just gonna assume that we've already done that because I'm a great developer and we don't need to test things. So what we now wanna do is deploy this to production. And the really cool thing I can do with GitHub is I can create releases. So I'll come over here and create a release. And it's likely when you're building an app, you're not republishing for every single little change you're making, right? You're coupling feature changes with bug fixes and kind of doing that as a stable release to a user. So you're probably putting many of these changes together and then releasing them to a user. So in this case, I'm just gonna version my release 1.01. And I'm gonna say, hey, we added the decline filter capability to my Power app. And so like this might be where I would do like a whole release notes section on what actually happened here, supposing I made multiple changes. So we'll go ahead and publish release and something really cool is gonna happen. So you can see here, I have latest release, added decline filter capability to my Power app. I can download this, so I have this really nice traceability. But if we go over to actions, we'll see that something is actually kicked off. We've kicked off this release solution to prod GitHub action. And so what this is actually gonna do is this is gonna take all of my solution that's represented in GitHub right now in source control. It's gonna package that up and it's gonna deploy that to my production environment that we talked about earlier within the Power Platform. And then my users are actually gonna be able to use that production app that I've made with these changes. And so what we've done is we've kind of flowed this application from development to this test environment. And finally, now we're moving into the production environment. Okay, so our release solution to production GitHub action has completed. And if we click over here, we can see that it goes and publishes this to my environment. So if we jump over to my production environment, so you can see I've now switched to my production environment. I'm going to go ahead and refresh. And you'll see modified 31 seconds ago. I haven't actually gone in and modified this in my production environment, but what we've done is we've taken that app that was in GitHub and pushed it directly into my production environment from GitHub. Pretty cool. So let's go ahead and run this application. And so we'll go ahead and log as an employee, and you can see that I have a bug I need to fix. I should file that in GitHub issues. And now we have this decline filter. So that's awesome. So what we did is we just showed the power, no pun intended, of GitHub and the Power Platform together. So first we represented that Power Platform solution that contained my app as a repository in GitHub. This gave us traceability for the changes we were making with change tracking. Next, we logged an issue with our GitHub issues for the app developer. After that, the app developer made changes in the development Power Platform environment without production affecting production users, represented those changes in a branch in GitHub using GitHub Actions. We then tested those changes, and then we deployed them into production using another GitHub action. And so this shows just how easy it is to deliver application lifecycle management, traceability with change tracking, and CI/CD with the Power Platform in GitHub.